stored energy in a volume charge distribution. We have already proved that the stored energy in a system of discrete charges equals half the summation of the value of these charges multiplied by the absolute potential at each charge. So, assuming that these charges are not discrete and they are consisting of a volume distribution, so instead of Q, we are going to replace Q by the volume charge density rho V multiplied by dV and replace the summation by integration over the volume. So in this case, we can say that the stored energy in a volume charge distribution would equal half the integration over the volume charge density multiplied by the electric potential distribution inside the volume dV, where V here is the volume or the integration on the volume. Alright, but from Gauss law, we know that the volume charge density rho V equals the divergence of the electric flux density. So we can replace this rho V by the divergence of the electric flux density. But before doing this step, let us first do some vector differentiation operation on VD. If we have the divergence of VD, where V is the potential and D is the electric flux density, so it is like any differential operator. We are going to take the derivative of the first term multiplied by the second term plus the first term multiplied by the derivative of the second term. So we can say that V multiplied by the divergence of D plus D dot the gradient of V. So in this case, we are going to replace this rho V by the divergence of D. So the stored electric energy in a volume charge distribution would be half the integration over the volume rho V multiplied by the potential V dV. It would be half the integration over the volume, the divergence of D multiplied by the potential V over the volume dV. But effectively, this term corresponds to this term, which is equivalent to the divergence of VD minus D dot the gradient of V. So we can replace this term, which corresponds to this term, by nabla dot VD minus D dot gradient V dV. Right? Okay. So the stored electric energy in this case would be half the volume integration of nabla dot VD minus D dot gradient V, and the integration is performed on the volume. Now, from the divergence theorem, we know that the integration over a closed surface of D dot dS equals the integration of the volume enclosed by this closed surface of the divergence of D dV. This was the divergence theorem which we have proved in Gauss law. So Now, we can replace the first integration by the integration over a closed surface. So, instead of the divergence of VD, we can say the integration over a closed surface, VD dot ds, and the other bar is still the same, of the integration of volume, gradient, the potential, dV. Now, assuming that we are going to integrate the stored energy over all the universe, so this surface is effectively in the limit when the distance extends to infinity. And we said that the potential at infinity equals zero. So effectively, the first integration with respect to the closed surface, where the surface is extending to infinity, is zero. So in this case, the stored electric energy would be minus half the integration of d dot gradient v dot v, dv. That's what we are saying. The surface integral is equal to zero for over this closed surface surrounding the universe, and we have v is proportional to zero, and when we are extending to infinity, because it is proportional to 1 over r or 1 over r squared or 1 over r cubed. So in general, the potential when we are extending r to infinity, the potential is zero, so this term is zero. So the stored electric energy now can be represented as minus half the integration over the volume d dot gradient v, or the gradient of the potential dv, which is the volume. Now, if we remember, minus gradient the potential is the electric field. So we can replace minus gradient the potential by the electric field. And the electric flux density is effectively equals epsilon E. So in this case, we can prove that the stored electric energy would be minus minus would be positive of d dot E dv. And d is epsilon not E. So in this case, it can be half epsilon naught E squared, or the modulus of the electric field squared dV. Or in other words, we can say that half epsilon naught E squared is the stored energy in the electric field per unit volume. So if we have electric field in some region, means that there is electrostatic energy, and this electrostatic energy equals half the integration of epsilon naught of the magnitude of the electric field squared dV. And it should be noted that the stored electric energy does not depend on the direction of the electric field, it depends on the magnitude of the electric field. So, as we increase the magnitude of the electric field, we are going to increase the stored energy in the electrostatic. Okay? Alright. Now, as an example, what would be the stored energy in a coaxial cylindrical structure? We have already proved that the electric field inside coaxial cylindrical structure in the range from rho equals A to B is A rho surface over epsilon naught rho in the direction of rho. So the magnitude of the electric field in this case will be A rho surface over epsilon naught rho. The stored energy would be half the magnitude of the electric field squared multiplied by epsilon naught. So epsilon naught over epsilon naught squared, A squared rho surface squared over rho. This dV multiplied by the volume. And the volume in the case of this cylindrical structure would be rho d phi dz, and the limits in the present case, rho would be from A to B, phi would be from 0 to 2 pi, and Z, we are going to assume we have a unit length, or the length from 0 to L. So, in this case, we are going to make this integration with respect to rho d phi dz. It would be by L A squared rho surface squared over epsilon, ln B over A, which is coming from rho over rho squared. So it is 1 over rho, d rho, it would be ln rho, so, and limit from B to A, so ln BA. Phi is constant, so it is 2 pi, and this 2 pi can be cancelled. 2 pi, over 2, it would be pi, and the integration with respect to Z would be Z, would be L. So, pi L A squared rho surface squared over epsilon naught ln B over A. This is the stored electric energy inside a coaxial structure of length A.